What's good, Grio fam? It's your girl Sierra, aka the Solo Travel Queen. Today we are out here with the Great Outdoor Series sponsored by Chevrolet. Join me as we travel across the nation showcasing Black organizations that are on a mission to shatter stereotypes that Black and Brown people may face in outdoor spaces. Today we are out here in the stunning Santa Cruz, California for some surfing with the Black Surf Club. We'll be discussing how you can achieve community and wellness through surfing. Let's go. Welcome, California.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for having me. Thank you for inviting me
of
out.
Course.
Surf
of course.
With Black Surf Club. Nice to meet you too.
We do have to try and get out in the water, so I'm going to go ahead and give you your wetsuit, and I'll tell you more about Black Surf after.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
We're just gonna take some time to like look at what's going on.
Yeah.
We'll stretch a little bit and then we'll grab our boards and we'll head out.
Yeah, get a good stretch in.
And how do I mentally prepare for this?
That's a great question. So kind of taking it in and starting to get an idea of what's actually happening out there really helps. Deep breaths, surfing really kind of requires like this surrendering aspect. So just surrender to being present, surrender to not fighting the waves.
So go with the flow.
To sound cliche, but yeah, you're just gonna go out there and kind of see what happens naturally.
Yeah.
Let's go get our boards and then we'll head out.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about Black Surf Club. What inspired the organization?
So Black Surf was started in 2020 after a series of protests. I had been organizing some protests on the land and saw a series of paddle out pictures that happened at the same time as one of my events. And the lineup was super white. It wasn't reflective of the audience and the folks that were in mourning of George Floyd. And so when I saw a flyer for an upcoming paddle out, I put a feeler out on social media and said, you know, would any white folks be willing to kind of hold back and leave their equipment? So provide a wetsuit or a board for Black folks and people of color to be able to participate. And to my surprise, people were like, yeah. And so we got a list of some odd like 20 to 25 people. We all went into the parking lot and suited up for the first time. And we paddled out and it was like the biggest feeling of community and sense of belonging I had ever had. And just kind of jokingly was like, let's start a Black Surf Club. And everyone was just so game, and that was the birth of Black Surf.
Oh, that's such a beautiful story. So like, tell me about both of your journeys with surfing. Because I know that you said it's been a few years. Was your first time with Black Surf Club? And I know for you,
it was also with Black Surf Club.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And it was great. The crazy part was that when we actually went to that first convening with Bella that she organized, not only was it so powerful to see people our age who were also Black, who were like from the community, who were coming out for the first time, meeting each other, who have lived here for so long.
Yeah.
But then when we just went out there into the ocean, we felt like we were safe.
It's crazy to see all of this, like this melanin. Like when
yes.
I was like, when we were paddling out, I was like, okay, this is it.
I've always felt the lineup shift when we come out. Like you see this melanin paddling out to this predominantly white lineup of people. And at first there's this hesitation. It's like we are almost segregated at first. Like you feel this degree of separation. And then, you know, by the time we're out there for a little bit, the whole energy shifts and you'll see, you know, the folks that were out there originally blocking for us, you know, cheering us on, making space for us, and we never even had to say anything.
What advice would you give to someone who wants to get into surfing, but they're intimidated by the sport or the water, or even just the people that they normally see out on the water?
Don't write yourself off, I would say. Don't fall into the traps of stereotypes of, you know, oh, Black folks don't swim, Black folks don't surf, like, no, like
yeah.
You literally have the opportunity to write your own destiny, and that's what I like, is like creating that autonomy for people to decide for themselves.
Okay, so where can one find out more about the organization? How can they get involved?
You can learn more at our website, which is blacksurfclubsantacruz.com. Our Instagram is blacksurfclubsantacruz, as well as Facebook. So those are the biggest platforms for now to tune in and be a part of the journey with us.
Thank you so much for having me. Yeah. This was so much fun. Like I said, y'all are the best hype man and hype woman.
Yeah.
And
thank you.
It was great getting out on the water. It's been great talking to you guys. Mm-hmm. And hope to meet again. Okay, y'all. So I had a few wipeouts, but surfing out here in Santa Cruz was everything. Shout out to Bella and Io for showing me how Black Surf Club does it. Now let me get out this wetsuit and I will see y'all next time on the Great Outdoor Series sponsored by Chevrolet.